I'm here in Oxnard, California with Roger Romo. He's a boxing prospect, and he's also the brother of Fernando Vargas. And we're at the home of Fernando in Oxnard. And check out his home gym. So give us a tour of the gym.
Yeah, the gym right here. You got your cables. You know, you got your curl bars. You got mirrors everywhere.
Some of the articles and posters.
Yeah, the article. This article right here is when he won the title, when he beat Yori Boy. That was in the front page here in Ventura County Star. So you got that.
But what's this one?
This right here, that's when they did a welcome home party for him.
What did you think about his haircut back then? Do you think he would do it going back? Would he do it again?
Maybe he can, but I don't think he wants to do that anymore. But I mean, that was him. He had a lot of people doing it. And you got a lot of cool things. Look at this thing right here. This is what gets me right here. It's awesome. You got, this is Fernando's Olympic team right here. And if you look at, I mean, look at the talent. You got Eric Morrell was a world champ. You got Zahir Rahim will beat Eric Morales. You got Floyd Money, of course. David Diaz was a world champ, of course. Fernando
Floyd
was a
Mayweather
champ.
Was his teammate.
Exactly. You got Antonio Tarver, David Reed. I mean, that was just a talented team.
David Diaz.
It was a really talented team. And then you see
Fernando team. Looks like a kid.
He was 18, barely gonna turn 18 to turn go into the games.
And then wasn't what's his name on the team too? Lehman Brewster.
No, he was an alternate. He was an alternate for either Nate Jones or Clay, but I'm not sure.
Were you there too?
No, I wasn't there. That was the one that was getting ready for the Kansas, games. Floyd, and Fernando, Tarver, and
Atlanta. Looking back at that picture, did you ever think going Floyd will be who he is, 42-0, 26 knockouts, and all the history, and you mentioned the name Floyd to anybody in the world, whether they're a boxing fan or not, with his legacy?
I mean, back then, I knew Floyd was one of the more talented ones on the team. Just like, you know, of course, Tarver and Fernando and Reed. But to where Floyd is not, I mean, I'm sure he always thought he was going to be like that. I knew he was going to be a world champ, but I didn't think it was going to be as crazy as it is now. And you see that? I mean, that's pretty crazy.
And then here's another fight poster.
So the Corte.
What do you remember from that fight?
That fight was brutal. He went, I think in the ninth round, in the fight, and Fernando's throwing over 100 punches around. And then he's coming into the eighth, and he's throwing over 100 punches in the ninth. Like, Fernando threw, I remember Jim Lampley saying, he threw over 100 punches this round, he threw over 100 punches the last round. If he has anything left, we're going to see it right now. And he comes out in the ninth round, and boom, 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 boom. Look at Fernando go. That's what I remember. I remember hearing that because he was throwing over 100 punches around each round for like towards the middle of the fight. It was pretty unheard of.
And what's this cutout right here?
This cutout.
Almost as tall as you,
6'1". That's a Miller Lite cutout. Miller Lite did that up. That was when he was
that's badass.
Yeah. So I remember.
Why Papa's?
Papa's is his firstborn son. You know, as it progressed, you know, the list got bigger with his kids, you know, but all with the same woman, all with his wife, you know, all of his boys, he had all his boys, and he was blessed with a little girl too. What was I going to tell you that, this is one thing I trip out on, like, this is when he fights Vanderpool, and look who's on the undercard.
Manny Pacquiao?
Yeah.
Let's look at his record back then, who he was. Manny Pacquiao. Well, 32 is like 20 fights ago, 27 KO. Today is like 55, 56 fights.
Yeah.
Hard punching southpaw.
Fly with the title, that's crazy, right?
Yeah, that's crazy that Manny was on his undercard.
No, I tripped out because this guy was from main events, and this guy was known to be pretty decent. When he fought him, Manny just annihilated him. I remember that fight too.
Really cool thing. I didn't know you had this at the house. What's it like to have such a piece of boxing history right here where you live every day? Roger, I would not leave the gym.
Man, I'm used to it, but you know, you do trip out in there at times. There's times I came up here and just looked at it and kind of just tripped out a bit. This was more
newspaper article.
Yeah, this is like when he was an amateur.
You ever wonder, because I'm sure there are some boxing fans that have this at their house just as fans, like their garage or converted. Because, you know, of stuff they collected over the years. But this is actually from real achievements. Like being in Ring Magazine. Did Ring Magazine give him this plaque?
Yeah, they made that. They sent that to him.
Why?
It was a big article. That was when he won the title, when he beat Yori Boy. You saw me, I was only 20, turned 21 right there. So it was a big article, and they sent it to him. And
were you with him at the fight?
Oh yeah, I was with him in the
camp. What was it like to be with him at camp, at the fight?
I was with him in every, damn near every camp, and that camp was extreme because we were up in Big Bear for 3 months. He wanted to make sure he was ready to go, and he,
did you buy a place up there?
He, at that point in time, he was renting a place. After that, he got his own place up there, really nice 5 acres, so it was huge.
And what was it like being away from home? How old were you? You must have been younger.
I was probably 16, if
that. Oh, that's not that young.
Yeah, I was like 16.
That's cool. Was it cold?
Yeah. And I remember I was running. I was doing everything with him. And the last run that we had up there was really rocky-esque. It was snowing hard. And that was the last run we had to do. But
And what else do you have here, Roger? So you have here all the weights. Who uses, honestly, who uses the 90-pound weights?
I do shoulder shrugs.
No, you don't.
Come on, man.
I'm not going to have you do it now because you have a fight in a week, but I got to come back and see you do it. And who do
it? Here's a 70. Here's a 70, just so I can do a shoulder shrug for you.
That's it?
Yeah, that's just a cool.
That's what you use 100 ones for, too?
You can.
Those are just for
your how about shadow box with 100-pound weights?
I think only Bear Capelli could do that. You got to talk about that one.
What can you tell me about this fight?
That was a classic fight, too.
They talk about it till today.
It was a classic fight, too. Well, see, this one says May 4th, and it took place in September.
Yeah.
He pulled out on the first time. I heard...
Why did they say... Okay, what did you
hear? I heard, well, from people that were in camp over there, that he said that he just wasn't ready. He wasn't going to fight.
Well, why bad blood if they're both Mexican Americans? They're both from Southern California. Just to hype it?
Nah, they really didn't like each other.
Really? But they're cool today, right?
I mean, cool into a sense of, you know, I'm sure. I mean, nothing will happen if they see each other. But I mean, they're cool. It can mean so many things. But yeah. They're not gonna go. They're not gonna be hanging out at the club together, going out and doing things.
Got a bench. What happens in every gym? Machines breaks. What do you do here if the bike goes out? The dinosaur here. What's it called? The T-Rex.
So then you gotta look at the manuals and learn how to operate it yourself.
Put it together.
Basically, yeah.
Man, that's really cool. I had no idea you had this at home. Do people know about this?
Yeah. Well, I mean, not everybody, but people like my friends and everybody like, man, I would never even leave. A lot of people say that. But
when you have it,
no, they'll have it and they won't do it themselves. They'll be like, okay, you say that, well, come and work out with us.
No, but it's kind of those things where you say, oh, if I only had it at home, I don't have to go to the gym. But it doesn't work like that.
It doesn't.
Roger, what am I looking at? All the 70 trophies and all kinds of medals.
I'm looking at a collection. Most of them were Fernando's. A few of them were up there that are mine. I won a few.
Why didn't Fernando take them with him?
I don't know. I don't know, he just left them there, I guess.
Are people impressed for him? When they come here and they see all like 70 trophies and medals and the key to the city of Oxnard? And
people always trip out on it. I mean, as a, you know, when you're a kid and you go into a friend's house and you see all their baseball trophies, well, that's all that Fernando's philosophy was. He just wanted to win trophies, and you can see he wanted to win. That's what he says, too.
He's all boxing.
He's like, I just wanted to win trophies, but a whole lot came out of that.
That's pretty cool. What was it like growing up with Fernando? Did you guys grow up in this house?
Yeah, we grew up in this house. It wasn't always as big, but this is where we grew up, in this pad right here. A lot of good stories in this house.
A lot of fighters walk through the doors?
He's had a lot of friends come through here. Robbie Peden was a world champ, too. He's from Australia. You had, Shibata Flores would always come over here.
I know Shibata, he likes to sing.
Yeah, Omar Shika came and stayed out here with us for a week. Who else? He's had a few of the sparring partners that came down that have been here. So, you know, of course, Robert. Robert's been here plenty of times. And
Robert's a cool dude.
Yeah, Robert's a real cool dude. We all like grew up together. They were all, I mean, they were older than me, but I kind of grew up.
You hung out around them a lot.
Yeah.
People always ask me, will Fernando Vargas make a comeback? People want to see him make a comeback. You think that would ever happen?
Nah, I think he's content to what he did in the sport and
youngest champion
ever.
Yeah,
he's good. He doesn't want to do it anymore. He's focused on his family now, and that's his life now.
He is 3point.com. I'm Melissa Beck reporting.